Today, I'm going to show you how to apply a vignette to your ArcGIS Pro layout directly in ArcGIS Pro. Lame, awesome. Lame, awesome. Here's a layout I've got in ArcGIS Pro showing a map of Slovenia. Now, I want to add a vignette to this. A nice, subtle, rounded, radial darkening at the edges to help draw the eye into the subject matter. Now, there's no feature called Add Vignette, but you can add what's called a map note, and I'll draw a polygon and give it a gradient fill, and then I'll apply a blend mode to that. So first I'm going to activate my map view. So I'm in my map now, and I'm going to insert a map note. And I'll choose polygon map notes. And this has stubbed in the polygon map notes group in my project's geodatabase. Now I just need to draw my shape. So I'll go to Edit, Create, Polygon Notes, and I'm going to draw a polygon that surrounds my map's area. One, two, and I'll pan my view over using the scroll bar. Three, double click, four corners. So when you're drawing, you'll be tempted to use your mouse to slide over your view, but that'll inadvertently change your map position. What you want to do is change the position of your layout. And when your map is active, you can just hold the one key and then pan your layout view without changing your map view. So now I've got a big rectangle surrounding my entire map view, just outside of it. Accept this, go to the Edit tab and save it. And close this. Now I have a polygon covering my map extent. I'll open the symbology for this polygon. And I don't need the outline. And instead of a solid fill, I'll choose a gradient fill. And the pattern will be circular. And instead of discrete, which is chunky layers, I'll make it continuous, which is a nice smooth transition from one color stop to the next. And I'll give the size of this 100%. So that the gradient fills the entirety of my shape. And I'll go from white on the inside to black on the outside. And congratulations, Nelson, you've just covered everything up. Now it's time to break out the blend modes. I'll select the feature layer, which is polygon notes, and the layer blend I'll set to the darkening mode of color burn. And it's a pretty extreme effect, obviously too extreme. So now we can just walk it back. Instead of black, let's start lightening this black and see what we get. Better. Better. And you can fine tune how deeply you want this effect to apply. Now my color gradient is going from the center to the outside, so that transition is covering the entirety of my map frame. Let's say I just want to push this effect more to the perimeter, like a true burned in vignette would be. I'll open the color properties of this gradient, and I'll just take this white color, which is neutral using this blend mode. I'll just push it in, hit okay. Now you can see that the effect will be pushed closer to the edges and more neutral in the center. Let's take a look at what we've got. With the vignette, without the vignette, with, without. It's subtle, ideally, but it can really help draw the eye to your area of interest and add a sense of depth and drama to your composition. This video was brought to you by Mike Lamb, one of my photography professors in college. He taught me how to paint with actual light in an honest-to-goodness darkroom. You put your negative up here behind a light bulb, and it would project light down onto your photographic paper. And then the magic was you'd use your hands or little tools you made out of paper to cast shadows on the paper. So you burn extra light into some places and dodge light in others. Burning made it darker. Dodging made it lighter. It's where a lot of these terms come from in graphic design, their photographic legacy. Anyway, thank you.